gathered today for the laying of the foundation stone of the Integrated Governmental Clearance Centre and the launching of the new mobile scanner procured by the MR. The International Customs Day this year will be dedicated to the contribution of customs towards a sustainable future where social, economic, health and environmental needs are at the heart of our actions with the slogan, Customs Fostering Sustainability for People, Prosperity and the Planet. On these words, I will now invite Mr. Sudhamulal, the Director General of the MRA, to deliver his welcome speech. Please.
The Honourable Pravin Kumar Jagnauth, Prime Minister, Republic of Mauritius, Honourable Ministers, Honourable Private Parliamentary Secretary, Honourable Members of the National Assembly, Chairperson of the MRA Board and Board Members, Vice Chairperson of the Crown Port District Council and Chairman of the Plain Manua Village, distinguished guests, ladies and gentlemen, good morning. It's an honor for me to welcome you all on the occasion of the laying of foundation stone of Integrated Governmental Clearance Centre and the International Customs Day celebrations. First of all, I express my warmest gratitude to you, Honourable Prime Minister, for kindly accepting our invitation to grace this occasion. We truly appreciate your valued presence amongst us today, despite your hectic schedule and especially on a Sunday. Honourable Prime Minister, I also wish to thank you for the special attention that you consistently impart to the MRA. Today, thanks to your VN, MRA is a strategic player in helping the government achieve its VN 2030 for transforming Mauritius into a high-income economy. We are contributing approximately 90% of the national budget through tax revenues collected. The revenue collected in the MRA has grown steadily over the years from 39.3 billion in 2010, it has reached 89.5 billion in the financial year 18-19, that is an increase of 82%. Today, we can proudly say that MRA is providing a world-class service and contributing to improve the trade and business. Ladies and gentlemen, customs administrations across the whole world celebrate the International Customs Day on January 26th every year. And today, despite being a Sunday, we have such a big gathering to mark this important event. I seize this occasion to wish all custom officers a happy International Customs Day. To mark the International Customs Day, the World Customs Organization dedicates a yearly theme that is pertinent to the challenges facing the global customs community. The theme of this year is Customs Fostering Sustainability for People, Prosperity and the Planet. This theme prompts us to make a reflection on the evolving role of customs. Modern customs does not only collect duty and taxes at importation, but it has a predominant role in the trade facilitation, protection of the society from the illicit entry of drugs, protection of the environment, natural heritage, and endangered species. Fake and counterfeit goods, as well as protection of intellectual property. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me to enumerate a few initiatives that the MRA has taken to promote the sustainability for people, prosperity, and the planet. Promoting sustainability for people, MRA has always given development of people a topmost priority. Training and capacity building activities are regularly organized in MRA's Training Academy, which is also a WCO regional training center. The figures for the past 5 years speak by themselves. 313 in-house training programs, 226 external training programs, and 601 overseas missions, making a total of 66,730 man days. MRA has hosted various trainings, workshops, and conferences under the aegis of WCO, SADC, African Union, African Tax Administration Forum, and other international organizations. Moreover, the resounding success of MRA on reforms and modernization is also attracting other revenue and customs administrations to benchmark on us. Several capacity building events and study tours from other relevant organizations have been organized. Promoting sustainability for prosperity. ICD 2020 slogan rightly depicts the role of customs, which is to protect the society from illicit entry of drugs, narcotics, and psychotropic substances. In this regard, I wish to express our gratitude to the Honorable Prime Minister for allocating the funds to the MRA to acquire the necessary tools and equipment to better fight against illicit drugs and narcotics. Promoting sustainability for the planet. MRA Customs plays a key role in implementing the government's policies regarding environmental protection. MRA Customs is presently administering the following taxes: environment protection fees, MID levy on coal and petroleum products, excise duty on household electrical appliances, and other environmental taxes such as on PET bottles, non-biodegradable plastic products, tires, pesticides, insecticides, mobile phones, and batteries. It's also to be noted that Mauritius is co-chair with New Zealand for the WCO Small Island Economies Initiative to assist SIEs in addressing their unique challenges on environmental and climatic issues. Ladies and gentlemen, today the Honorable Prime Minister will be proceeding with the laying of the foundation stone of the Integrated Governmental Clearance Centre. It gives me much pride to say that we are very indeed fortunate to have a Prime Minister who has a very keen interest for business facilitation and welfare of the trading community. Our Prime Minister welcomed this initiative and did not hesitate an iota to earmark the necessary budget for this project. The IGCC will have a total surface area of 4,800 square meters. The main building will comprise of a ground plus two floors. A two-story ancillary building will have a total area of 1,140 square meters, comprising a cafeteria, auditorium, and mezzanine floor. It will be an integrated building that will host customs and other border controlling agencies under one roof, thereby promoting the innovative concept of coordinated border management as recommended by the WCO. Stakeholders, including various government agencies, ministries, and departments of the government, will also be able to conduct all transactions such as application of permits and authorizations, payment of fees, duty and taxes, and clearance of goods in a single building. All these measures will facilitate trade, reduce the cost of doing business, and dwell time. Ladies and gentlemen, MRA Customs have several projects in the pipeline, some of which are additional scanners for consignments, X-ray body scanner for passengers, a modern CCTV control room, extra drones for port security, body-worn camera to enhance the integrity process of examination of goods, extended examination base to reduce cargo dwell time, e-application for binding rulings, and big data analytics. Our Prime Minister, I don't know if it's a mere coincidence or a fortunate twist of fate, but you have always been associated with major events taking place in the short history of the MRA. You will recall that you were the Minister of Finance who introduced the MRA Bill in the National Assembly in 2004. A bill which led to the creation of the Mauritius Revenue Authority. Today, the MRA is considered as one of the biggest experiments in change management in the public service. It has reformed and modernized revenue administration to such an extent that the country is now ranked 5th worldwide in ease of paying taxes. These achievements would not have been possible without your political will to create the MRA and your dedicated leadership in moving it forward. It's again under your leadership as Minister of Finance in February 2011 that was inaugurated our first major wholly owned building, the new Custom House at Mauritius. Today, we are laying the foundation stone of another wholly owned MRA building, the Integrated Government Clearance Centre, that is IGCC. Thank you, Honourable Prime Minister, for the modernisation of the Customs Department with such dedicated and high-tech buildings. But I also have a plea for me and our staff, for their own wholly owned building, their revenue house. To accommodate some 700 MRA officials, our current tax headquarters at Aram Court has already been stretched to its limit and no longer meets our future aspirations to be a world-class revenue authority. I would be grateful, sir, if you would kindly request the Minister of Finance, who is amongst us today, to make provision for a smart revenue house in his next budget. I can assure you, sir, that we will work with similar zeal and passion to ensure that government reaps the reward of the money invested through sustained improvements in delivery of services, ease of doing businesses, and revenue collections. I thank all the honorable ministers, MPs present, and all the related government agencies and stakeholders for their esteemed presence today, and I invite their collaboration with the MRA to make Mauritius a peaceful and prosperous nation, a safe place to live, free from the ills of drugs and counterfeit products. With these words,
Ladies and gentlemen, I thank you for your kind attention.
May I kindly invite Dr. the Honorable Ranganathan Padayachi on stage, please. MRA is pleased to offer a token to the Honorable Minister of Finance, Economic Planning and Development on the occasion of the International Customs Day. Ladies and gentlemen, we are now going to watch a 3D video which will showcase the salient features of the IGCC, which you are viewing on the screen as a static picture.
The Mauritian airport landscape will soon be offering a one-stop shop service for the expedient clearance of cargo and passengers, thus creating a new conducive business environment for trade facilitation. The Integrated Governmental Clearance Centre, the IGCC, presents itself as one of its kind within the cargo village. The IGCC comprises a major administrative block, an auditorium, a canine kennel, a warehouse, among other facilities. An environment-friendly concept, the IGCC has also been designed to integrate solar panels for the production of energy. In line with this year's WCO theme, the building ensures sustainability, being fitted with solar e-glasses, thus minimizing energy consumption. Natural ventilation and natural lighting add value to its modern concept. Move inside the administrative block. A welcoming space greets the stakeholder to transact in a coordinated approach with various trade-related agencies and customs. This service will reduce cargo dwell time and associated costs. Clearance of goods will no doubt be seamless. The auditorium of the IGCC will be hosting conferences, workshops, seminars. Participants, both local and international, will be able to avail themselves of translation facilities. It will equally be hosting events. The IGCC, more than just a one-stop shop for the clearance of cargo, it aims at taking customs services to higher levels, thus consolidating MRA's vision as a world-class revenue authority. Customs authorities the world over are adopting a modern approach to cope with increasing cargo volume and ensure a better border control. Member countries of the World Customs Organization, like the United States, the Netherlands, already moved towards mobile container scanners using non-intrusive state-of-the-art technology in the fight against the movement of illicit goods. To keep pace with change, the Mauritius Revenue Authority has acquired a similar mobile container scanner to optimize the examination of containerized goods. This initiative is in line with international best practices such as the WCO Safe Framework of Standards, the revised Kyoto Convention, and the World Trade Organization Trade Facilitation Agreement. Since its inception in 2006, the MRA has had recourse to various types of scanners in the port, at the airport, the parcel post office, and at the Plaisance Air Transport Services for the examination of consignments. The recently acquired scan van is highly effective in the scanning of loose consignments. The new mobile container scanner is one of the best mobile scanners available on the market. It produces high-resolution scanned images for more precise analysis. It possesses a high steel penetration capacity of up to 330 mm. No doubt, this new mobile container scanner will act as a deterrent to the entry of prohibited illicit goods in Mauritius. Trendy, this scanner can move towards containers rather than having containers move towards fixed scanners. The mobile container scanner comes at a time when the port in Mauritius is undergoing major transformation. The Mauritius Revenue Authority pursues its endeavor in promoting a secure business and trade environment in line with the government's vision.
I now have the honour and privilege to invite the Honourable Pravin Kumar Jagnath, Prime Minister, to deliver his keynote address on this auspicious occasion.
It is a pleasure for me to be in your midst this morning for the laying of the foundation stone of the Integrated Governmental Clearance Centre. We are, of course, also celebrating today, the International Customs Day. And I think it could not have been a more appropriate day to hold this function. As Mauritius moves towards a new, more open economy, trade facilitation will be critical to our success. And in that context, the new Integrated Governmental Clearance Centre will play a pivotal role. Mauritius was already one of the first countries to adopt the Trade Facilitation Agreement. Our plan is to build on this achievement and to continue to move along this path. We shall support organizations like the Mauritius Revenue Authority, which are keen to implement our policy and ensure openness to trade and investment with the rest of the world. The need for an Integrated Governmental Clearance Centre, the IGCC, was underlined by the World Customs Organization in its recommendation for a coordinated border management. This one-stop shop is a tool that can bring under one roof several government agencies that deal with the processes and of permits and authorizations as well as clearance of goods. The IGCC building will regroup customs officers and officers of other border controlling authorities responsible for the clearance of goods and passengers at the airport. It will also act as a focal point that will bring together relevant actors from customs to health, agriculture, commerce, food import unit, Mauritius Standards Bureau, and Pharmacy Board, amongst others. Coordinated border management promotes synergy and collaboration between governmental agencies, and it results in an integrated approach that provides more effective delivery of service and optimum use of available resources, better connectivity with stakeholders, and wider sharing of information and intelligence. The trading community will benefit in terms of reduced transactions costs through fast processing and clearance times, reduced hassles, and less waiting times. All these factors will contribute to reduce the cost of doing business. This building will cost around 650 million rupees and should be completed by June 2021. It will mark a major milestone in the facilitation of trade in Mauritius. Government will spare no effort to further reduce the cost of doing business and improve our ranking in the ease of doing business index. The IGCC will be unique with modern architectural design. It will be an eco-friendly building, encompassing green concepts and making optimal use of solar energy, natural lighting, and rainwater harvesting systems. Ladies and gentlemen, other major developments are in the pipeline at the airport. We intend to build a new passenger terminal. This will enable us to cope with the growing passenger traffic of more than 3.5 million every year. The coming into operation of the new passenger terminal and the IGCC will act as engines of our economic growth with the swift movement of air cargo, courier, and passengers. In addition, our new projects are expected to generate substantial employment for the surrounding villages and accelerate the modernization process currently taking place in those regions. Ladies and gentlemen, our outstanding performance at the World Bank's Ease of Doing Business Index 2020 is the result of reforms and measures that have been implemented since 2015. We have implemented, amongst others, a national electronic licensing system, a single electronic platform for business licensing. And to further improve business and investment climate, we have secured funding from the European Union under the Interim Economic Partnership Agreement. Consultants are being recruited to carry out a gap analysis and recommend the way forward. We are already the leader in business facilitation in the region. We now have ambitious plans to make Mauritius one of the world leaders in this field. Ladies and gentlemen, allow me now to convey my heartfelt wishes to all customs officers on the occasion of the International Day, Customs Day. The theme for this year is the contribution of customs towards a sustainable future where social, economic, health, and environmental needs are at the heart of our actions. Its slogan, Customs Fostering Sustainability for People, Prosperity and the Planet, is very closely associated with our vision for a better society where people live in peace and harmony. And in line with this commitment, our fight against the scourge of drugs and narcotics is, of course, a top priority. Our battle against drug trafficking is relentless. Record seizures of different types of drugs and psychotropic substances valued at around 4.6 billion rupees have been made since January 2015. We shall, of course, continue to provide unflinching support to the MRA in the fight against drug trafficking and narcotics. Adequate funds have been allocated to the MRA to acquire state-of-the-art tools and equipment. And I'm pleased to announce that we are launching a new mobile container scanner today. It was acquired at a cost of 73 million rupees and will increase scanning capacity for containers at the Mauritius Container Terminal and other container parks. This fully autonomous system can be used to scan goods anywhere in Mauritius. The scanner works well even in harsh weather conditions. It provides ample mobility and will enhance the efficiency of our fight against illicit trafficking. I will now mention some other equipment recently acquired by customs. Two fast interceptor boats to allow for better intervention and surveillance in and outside harbour, as the maritime route represents high risk for drug trafficking. And additionally, two rigid hull interceptor boats were purchased in 2019 to support the existing fleet. The MRA has bought three drones at a total cost of 1.5 million rupees for surveillance and information gathering in the port, its surroundings, and difficultly accessible regions. MRA Customs is currently operating express scanners at various strategic points at the port, airport, freight stations, and courier services. And in 2017, a mobile scan van was acquired to be deployed in freight stations for scanning of small consignments and at the cruise jetty for the screening of passenger luggage. In 2019, five additional sniffer dogs were acquired to reinforce the customs canine unit, which currently comprises a total of 15 sniffer dogs. Other drug detection equipment, such as wireless fiber scopes, buster contraband detector, and handheld backscatter scanners and narcotics analyzer, have been purchased by the MRA at a total cost of around 15 million rupees. International Customs Day is also an opportune moment to acknowledge the efficiency of the MRA in terms of revenue collection, very important for the government. That's why also we give considerable attention to the MRA. Its total contribution to the consolidated fund has risen from 64 billion rupees in 2014 to nearly 90 billion rupees in the last financial year. This progression in tax revenue provides greater scope to implement our policy in favor of inclusive growth and sustainable development. And this is not due because there has been an increase in taxes. In fact, on the contrary, there has been decrease in taxes, but the economic space is growing at a much faster pace so that we are able to collect more revenue. Ladies and gentlemen, we are determined to improve the well-being of each and every Mauritian and to make Mauritius prosperous. And I know that many of you share our vision. And I wish to express my gratitude to those who are contributing to the success of our mission. And to conclude, of course, I have taken note of what the Director General has said in terms of his request. In fact, this is not the first time. When I was Minister of Finance, we have had discussions. I must say that the MRA House is, of course, a priority project. But of course, I can't speak on my own now that we have a new Minister of Finance. Of course, the matter will be discussed. And I am confident that with time, as you have just said, Director General, we have had so many accomplishments. And with the vision that we have for the country and for the MRA, I'm sure that there are other things that we will be able to achieve together. Thank you for your kind attention.
The
Ladies and gentlemen, we will now proceed with the award of WCO certificates of merit to deserving organizations and officers. Sometimes back, it was only a unit in an organization responsible for keeping records of employees. In this modern era, it is a department with the responsibility of hiring the right person for the organization, providing training, and selecting the most suitable officers for promotion. In addition, this department is assigned the responsibility of looking after the welfare, safety, security, and security of employees. It is the Human Resource and Training Department. Today, we are honoring the Human Resource and Training Department of the MRA, represented by Director Mr. Vijay Ambandan. Set up to introduce the concept of focused targeting, whereby consignments are targeted on the basis of advanced information, database, social media, and intelligence gathered on the field. The whole targeting process is dynamic, and the selection criteria change and evolve as the business and trading environment change. The Brigade des Marchandises was created in 2016. Since 2018, as of now, this unit has collected 6 million rupees as additional duty and taxes and has suspended and detained IPR infringed goods for the value of 104 million. Today, we are honoring the Brigade des Marchandises, represented by team leader Uttam Persan. Every consignment entering Mauritius by sea has to be cleared through a bill of entry. The bill of entry is processed by a dedicated unit where compliance checks are done to ensure that the goods are properly declared and the right amount of duty and taxes are paid. This first level of check is instrumental for determining additional in-depth documentary or physical examination. This unit was operating from 9 to 4, but we start every day with a blank page. The officers have voluntarily welcomed the introduction of a shift system starting at 7 in the morning to end at 9 in the night. This has resulted in important gains in terms of cost, dwell time, overall trade facilitation for economic operators. Ladies and gentlemen, we are honoring the compliance unit of the Seaport Operations Section, represented by Technical Officer Jean-Marc Kanji. Another section was set up in August 2016 as a dedicated team to combat drug trafficking at borders. As at today, they have seized 115 kg of heroin, 42.6 kg of hashish, 21 kg of cannabis. These are contributions through networking, which were seized in friendly countries, Madagascar, Reunion, and South Africa. As at date, this unit has seized in Mauritius some 4.4 billion rupees of street value as illegal drugs. Today, we are honoring the Customs Anti-Narcotics Section, represented by Technical Officer Hemra Singh Bechu, posted at the Airport Customs Anti-Narcotics Unit. Organizations operating in the port area are traditionally male-dominated, but with the inception of MRA, there is no gender discrimination in recruitment in the Customs Department. They form part of the first batch of female officers who have taken up the challenge to perform in an environment which is traditionally dominated by male staff. They are also among the best officers with outstanding performance, having raised consequent amount of additional duty and taxes following examination of goods. In recognition of the work done by female officers at the examination section, we are honoring, firstly, Mrs. Dudesha Ruwa Kunj Bihari. And Mrs. Deepa Kodi. MRA Customs works in close collaboration with this ministry at the borders with the objective to address the illicit trade in hazardous waste and ozone-depleting substances in accordance with the Montreal Protocol. As the authority responsible for the management of solid waste, MRA collaborates with this ministry for the disposal of solid, unclaimed, abandoned, and condemned goods in the prescribed manner aimed at fostering sustainability for the planet, in line with this year's WCO slogan. We are pleased to honor the Ministry of Environment, Solid Waste Management, and Climate Change represented by Mr. Yaya Patel, Acting Deputy Director of Environment. It is an NQA licensed training institution set up in the year 2006 to fill a vacuum in the logistics industry. It is a pioneer institution in Mauritius to provide efficient and effective training in customs clearance and freight sector. Ladies and gentlemen, we want to place on record the contribution of the Freight Academy in the training of customs clerks, agents and brokers. The Freight Academy is represented by its principal, Mr. Brahmanan Jirakhan.
Thank you very much, Prime Minister and DG, for doing the honors. The Honorable Prime Minister is kindly invited to proceed with the laying of the foundation stone of the IGCC.
Container scanner. Honorable Minister of Finance, Chairperson, DG and Director Customs, please accompany the Honorable Prime Minister.
Sir, this is an innovative X-ray mobile inspection system with a latest state-of-the-art technology, and it is manufactured by one of the leading manufacturer of scanners in the world, and it can be deployed very rapidly.
Yeah.
The system, it has a steel penetration capacity of 330 millimeters. That is, the X-ray can go beyond 330 millimeters, and it also has a wire detection capacity of 0.1 millimeter, very high size. And it uses a dual energy technology to produce very high quality scan images, and it makes material discrimination. That is, it has a capacity to discriminate between organic, inorganic, and metallic materials. And it also adopts a force scan technology, enabling customers to scan between 20 to 25 scanners per hour. Okay, once it is clear, the scan is launched, and it takes less than 2 minutes to scan a whole container. And the scan image is transmitted.
What is the distance of the zone that has to be kept free?
It is 48 meters by 10 meters. Yeah. 48 meters by 10 meters. Good. Yes. And when the image is transmitted, within seconds, this is IPS, the image processing station, which is a very powerful software with different tools which help us to make a better analysis and interpretation of the scan image.
So this is like a real container?
This is the scan image of a container.
Yeah,
no. When we use different tools, we can arrive to detect. For example, we are using a stepless technology. You see the density inside the cylinder?
Yeah. Yeah.
So if we look at it with naked eyes, you won't see it.
Yeah.
Okay, now with the help of this tool, it is possible to us to detect illicit goods contained, concealed inside the package.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you for your
visit. Ladies and gentlemen, we have now come to the end of this section. Thank you for your kind attention.